Leonar has told me of the battle. You have served me well. I hope you continue to do so. You are to accompany Leonar to Fydok Castle, a Buckram holding.
Fydok Castle? Where the Dark Knights are garrisoned? Why there?
I want you to forge a treaty of non-interference before the real fighting with Golgastan begins. Not with the Buckram, mind you, but with the Dark Knights of Lodis. We cannot have them hounding our flank while we are occupied with Golgastan.
But, Your Grace, it was the Buckram who brought on this war. Our parents died on Roslorian swords. Had they not aided the Buckram, how much suffering might we have been spared?
None know this better than I, Kashua. But consider what would happen were we to face such a foe in open battle. They would crush us. The Buckram people, overfed swine that they are no threat. Ah, but the Dark Knights. There is a foe to be feared. Which is why we must swear our allegiance to Lodis and ensure that they are no foe of ours.
So Your Grace means to bend a knee to Lodis?
Tread carefully, Vice. I have told you, we are of one mind on this. I know the devil's bargain we make with Lodis. But it's only until we can deal with Golgastan and Balbatos. With the Dark Knights at bay, those opportunists in the Golgastani camp clamoring for war will fall silent. There's our chance. Once Balbatos is dead and buried, only then do we turn to strike the Buckram. What does our holy knight make of this? The Zenobian throne has no designs on Valeria. No Lodis they. Surely then, King Tristan would not object to a treaty of non-interference. A gesture of support for our burgeoning state. Ah, but I forget, this has no bearing on you, Sir Lancelot. Forgive me. Well, the sooner you and Leonar have left for Fydok, the better. A purse of 5,000 goths should help you see to your needs. I'll not have you depart unprepared.
Welcome. well.
Thank you.